Hello everyone, I welcome you all to K.R. Lakkam CBSE School Mudur online classes. So today I will start to discuss about exercise 6.3. In exercise 6.3, this is the first problem. This is the diagram they are given. So what they are asking here, in the figure QP and RQ are produced to points S and T respectively. QP is extended to S and like that only RQ produced T. If angle SPR is equals to 135 degrees and angle PQT is equals to 110 degrees, find angle PRQ. We have to find out angle PRQ. So we have to find out this angle. So now by observing these given values, means they have given that angle SPR is equals to 135 degrees and angle PQT is equals to how much? 110 degrees. So now we have to calculate angle PRQ. So to calculate this angle, at least minimum of we should know these two angles values. So to calculate these two angle values, what we can do, they have given this as 110 degree and this as 135 degree. So here these two angles are making linear pairs like this only. Here also these two angles are making linear pairs. By using linear pair, we can calculate this angle and this angle. By using these two values, by the angle sum property, we can calculate angle PRQ. See here, first using linear pair, here angle PQT plus angle PQR, this angle and this angle is equals to how much? 180 degrees, because of linear pair. And here we know value of angle PQT as 110 degrees, they have given this, plus angle PQR is equals to 180 degrees. So now to calculate angle PQR, what we can do, we will move this 110 degree to other side, which means 180 minus 110 degree. 180 minus 110 degree means how much? I will get angle PQR as 70 degree only. Like this, I will calculate angle PRPQ. I will calculate this angle using linear pair only. So here I will write angle RPQ means this angle RPQ plus angle SPR means this angle is equals to 180 degrees. These two angles are linear pairs. Therefore here we have the value of angle SPR as 135 degrees. Therefore here I will write angle RPQ plus SPR means 135 degrees is equals to 180 degrees. Now we can calculate angle RPQ value is equals to 180 degrees minus 135 degrees. I will move this 135 to the other part. Therefore 180 minus 135 degrees. 180 minus 135 degree means how much I will get? 45. 180 minus 135 means 45. Now we got the values of two angles here. This angle is 70 degree and this angle is 45 degree. So by using these two angles, we can calculate angle PRQ. So here I will write, we have to calculate angle PRQ only. Using angle sum property, angle sum property of triangle, what we can write here? Angle RPQ, angle RPQ plus angle PQR plus angle PRQ is equals to how much? According to use angle sum property of triangle, it is 180 degree. So here we have the values of angle PQR. Angle PQR is 70 degree and angle RPQ is 45 degree. Here angle RPQ just now we have calculated, which is 45 degree, plus angle PQR which is 70 degree, plus we have to calculate this angle PRQ which is equals to 180 degree. Here 70 plus 45 means how much you will get? 115 degree plus angle PRQ is equals to 180 degree. Now we can calculate angle PRQ is equals to 180 degree. I will move this 150 degree to other side, therefore 100 minus 115 degree, therefore angle PRQ is equals to how much? 180 minus 115 degree means I will get answer as 65 degree. This is the final answer. So here what we did, they have given this as 135 degree, they have given this 110 degree, and they asked to calculate this angle. So by using linear pair, we can calculate this angle. These two are linear angles, linear pairs, therefore we can calculate this angle. Like this only we can calculate this angle by using linear pairs, because these two are linear pairs, and by using this linear pair we got the values of these two angles in a triangle, and by using the angle sum property now we can calculate remaining angle in the triangle. Okay, now I will solve the next one. So here in second problem, this is the given diagram, and what they are asking here in figure, angle X is 62 degree. This is 62 degree, angle X is equals to 62 degree. Angle XYZ means angle XYZ, this is 54 degree. Angle XYZ, this complete angle is 54 degree. XYZ is equal to 54 degree. If YO and ZO, YO and ZO are bisector of XYZ, bisector of angle XYZ. Bisector means this YO divides this angle XYZ equally. So XYZ, angle XYZ is divided equally by the line YO. Like that only, here also angle XZY, this angle is divided by OZ of triangle XYZ. Find angle OZY. We have to find out angle OZY, means this angle, this is the angle OZY, and again they are asking angle YOZ means YOZ means this angle we have to calculate. Angle YOZ. So here we have to calculate these two angles. First, here they have given angle X value and angle XYZ value, and by using angle sum property we can calculate this angle XZY, this angle. Okay, here I will calculate by using angle sum property. Angle sum property, what we can calculate? Angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z is equals to how much? 180 degree. Angle sum property means, so sum of interior angles of triangle always equals to 180 degree. Here we have the angle X value as 62 degree plus angle Y value 54 degree plus we have to calculate here we have to calculate angle Z value is equals to 180 degree. So here 62 plus 54 degree means how much you will get? 62 plus 54 means here I will calculate 62 plus 54, 4 plus 2 6, 6 plus 5 116. So here 62 plus 54 means 116 degree plus angle Z is equals to 180 degree. And now I will calculate angle Z is equals to 180 degree. I will move this 116 to the other part, therefore it is minus now, minus 116 degree. So therefore angle Z is equals to how much? 180 minus 116 degree means how much we will get? 64 degree. Now we got the value of angle Z. We got the value of this complete angle. So now by using these values, angle Z and angle Y values, we can calculate angle OYZ and OZY. How? They have given that this OY is bisecting angle XYZ. So here I can write angle OYZ, angle OYZ means this angle, angle OYZ is equals to 1 by 2 into angle XYZ means OYZ is half of the angle XYZ because this OY is bisecting the angle XYZ. So here I can write 1 by 2 into what is angle XYZ? 54 degree. So 2 into 54 means here I can divide it. 2 2's are 4 and 1 is remaining, it becomes 14, 2 7's are 14. Therefore angle OYZ is 27 degree. Now like this only we can calculate angle OZY. Angle OZY is equals to 1 by 2 into angle XZY because here also OZ is bisecting the angle XZY. Therefore OZY is equals to 1 by 2 into angle XZY, which means 1 by 2 into angle XZY. Here we got the answer as 64 degree. Therefore 1 by 2 into 64. Here we can divide 2 1s are 2 3s are 6 and 2 2s are 4 means 32 degree. Now we got the values of angle OYZ, this angle OYZ, and angle OZY means this angle. So now they are asking angle YOZ means we have to calculate this angle also. So here we have these two values. By using this we can calculate angle YOZ. Here by using angle sum property. Angle sum property, we can calculate angle YOZ. How? Here angle OYZ, OYZ plus angle OZY plus angle YOZ is equals to 180 degree. So these are the angles inside this triangle YOZ, in triangle YOZ. So here these are the three angles. Always sum of the interior angles of triangle will be 180 degree only. And we have the value of angle OYZ. What is that? 27 degree plus angle OZY 32 degree plus angle YOZ is equals to 180 degree. So now 27 plus 32 means how much you will get? 27 plus 32 means 59 degree plus angle YOZ is equals to 180 degree. So now to calculate angle YOZ, what we can do? I will move this 59 degree to other part. Angle YOZ minus angle YOZ is equals to 180 degree minus 59 degree. Therefore angle YOZ is equals to how much? 180 minus 59 degree means angle YOZ is equals to 180 minus 59 means 121 degree. So this is the final answer. Here what we did, they are given angle X as 62 degree and this angle as 54 degree, and they are given that this OY and OZ, these two lines are bisecting angle Y and angle Z. So we have to calculate this angle and angle OZY, this angle. So before calculating these two angles, first I will calculate angle XZY by using the angle sum property. Here I got the value as 64 degree, and now we can calculate the values of angle OYZ and angle OZY, because these two angles are half of the angle XYZ and XZY. So we got the values as 27 degree and 32 degree. Here it is 27 degree and this is 32 degree. By using these two values, we can calculate this angle by using the angle sum property. Now I will solve the third problem. So here in third problem, what do I learn? In the figure, this is the figure they are given. Here AB is parallel to DE and angle BAC, this angle is 35 degree, and angle CDE, angle CDE is 53 degree, and they are asking angle DCE. So here they are asking angle DCE. So now what we can do, angle BAC, this angle BAC is equals to angle CED, because these are angle BAC and CED are, these two angles are alternate interior angles. These are alternate interior angles. So here angle CED is equals to, angle CED equals to 35 degree only, because this is equals to angle BAC. So now we got the value of CED as 35 degree, and they are asking angle DCE, means they are asking this angle. So now we can calculate this angle by using the angle sum property of triangle. So now I will use angle sum property of triangle, where sum of the all the interior angles of triangle will be equal to how much? 180 degree. So here what I will write, angle CDE plus angle CED plus angle DCE. Angle DCE is equals to how much? 180 degree. So now we know value of angle CDE. What is that? 53 degree plus angle CED is 35 degree plus we have to calculate this angle DCE. So here I will write angle DCE is equals to 180 degree. So now 53 plus 35 means how much? 88 degree. If you add 53 plus 35, we will get 88 degree plus angle DCE is equals to 180 degree. Now I can calculate angle DCE. How? Is equals to 180 degree minus 88 degree. Therefore, angle DCE is equals to 180 minus 88 degree means how much? 180 minus 88 means I will get answer as 92 degree. This is our final answer. So what I have given here, this is 35 degree and this is 53 degree, and we have to calculate this angle DCE. So first what I did here, angle BAC is equals to CED. These two angles are alternate interior angles, and now I got the two angles of angle triangle CDE. So this is 53, this is 35. Now I have to calculate this angle by using the angle sum property, and final answer angle DCE I got as 92 degree. So I hope all of you are clear with these three problems. In next class I will continue with further problems. Thank you all.